Mr. Speaker, African-American and minority voter disenfranchisement is well documented at this point empirically and experientially. A study done by the Public Religion Research Institute in July of last year found that just about every issue identified as a common barrier to voting had African-American and Hispanic voters being twice as likely to have experienced that issue. And so much like the poll taxes and the literacy tests, these policies, like the elimination of straight ticket voting, appear racially neutral, but over time, the results clearly indicate a racial bias in those areas affected. And a resuscitation of such practices, we should all hope, would be ended on a day like today. In the 2016 presidential election, the Wisconsin voter ID law kept Democrats away from polls in numbers larger than our elected president's margin of victory. The biggest decreases in turnout were in African American neighborhoods, an obvious signal that minority voters were disproportionately hurt by the voter ID law. And again, policies that appear racially neutral but overwhelmingly impact minorities are not racially neutral and should be seen for what they are, detrimental. Regardless of its form, regardless of its intent, voter suppression tactics have been successful in preventing and discouraging minorities from voting. Disenfranchising minorities has a long history in America, and it continues to take on a different form while continuing to suppress minority votes. And so, I believe a no vote on this day is a step towards its final burial, and it's why I'll be voting no and asking my colleagues on both sides of the aisle to join me in voting no to SB 48. Thank you so much.